size to know if it can look legitimately. So I would do that, I did that, this kind of procedure for some of these things earlier, measure it with a micrometer and put in the numbers. Clearly you can edit down here, make that 8.25 or something, or make this 5.68, all of that's just to be done. Might position it up there, so that's the basic method of working. Then I'm going to do a contextual menu, so I'm doing the F6 trick on there. Every second, I'm going to do head builder. Second, so these are called scripts, so it's something to take a wee moment to operate when you're using the program for the first time. So you seem to be paused sometimes. So it's creating a nice little setting with the things. I can then maybe squish about that setting. Something like that. Change the shape of the claws or something. Change the shape of that bit. Screw it all up a bit. Squish it a bit more. Nudge them in a wee bit. Yeah, I've got notes on this stuff I haven't printed yet. That will be handed out. So we'll just have
I don't see where you're picking on.
There's all sorts of funny wee things. P for prong. There's yeah. What it is. R for real. In there. R for real. Move that up a wee bit. Move that in a wee bit. Play about with all these things. There's a bit of kind of aesthetic consideration that I like when people cook with things and people can play about with this stuff.
You know, my stupid question, David, but you know when you bring the claw back against the stone, does he create a gap by himself? You don't need to create, you don't like to do a cut?
To cut it out there, you need to put a cutter in there to chop it a bit there. And I would tend to not do that. I've just done that, just snatching anything there. I would do that for render purposes, but not do that for printing and making purposes. You want this pause to be outside the stone, but for rendering, you want it to look as if it's already squished together on the set.
Just in case the stone's slightly different
when
it shrinks.
So, a little bit of room to maneuver. Yes, the problem is, I've got a bit small. So that's the rail, that's the cross section of that rail bit that goes around there. There's a Pac-Man looking thing going on and so on. Mm-hmm. There's various bits and bobs. That there, see that one? Mm-hmm. That bit up. So that there. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that?
I feel that way.
Why not?
Because it's smudge when you're printing and it would have the nice lines.
So it's never going to work. I don't know what the distance is between there and there, but it's not very much. Mm-hmm. It's never really going to print and it's never really going to. And how would you polish it? Mm-hmm. How would you finish when you measure all the lines? If it was a really chunky big wedding ring or something, that each one of these was a mil wide, mm-hmm. different kettle fish, there's all sorts of circumstances when these can get obvious. And it might be okay if you're just designing simply for the aesthetic. So you're just designing something to put in this picture of a bit of jewelry, you put these lines in, and that's a separate thing. And some parts of the program are absolutely like that.